adore me. And when I look, the moon had turned to gold, my favorite jewelry, blue moon. Now I'm no longer alone, without a dream in my heart, without a love of my own. It's your fault. Blue moon, we have to finish. In a moment, too much for me altogether. My favorite song from Lord. Thank you, Rusty. I love you. Bye.
Well, what a show!
What a show. Leaning on the
piano.
Bit
of music.
Beautiful music.
That's very relaxed, very sort of upbeat, very...
Yeah, a bit of jazz is always good
very
for the soul.
Very, nice. Very bluesy, wasn't it? Mm. And with Danny here, you know, bluesin.
Bluesin is the Yiddish word of the week.
Yeah.
Er hat gebluesen, the harmonica.
Yeah, he blew. He and I've said that to Did Danny he? Many times, mainly when he's... Thank you. When he's done my tax returns, because he's my accountant. Very good accountant,
really?
Not available.
He's not available.
I have
no idea.
We call him Count Danny, you know, like Count Basie.
I've known a few accountants who've blown it.
Yeah, he blows.
Yeah, does he blow your return every year?
Blows.
So Yiddish word for blow is bluesen.
Blues.
Blues.
Blues means blow.
Yeah, so yeah. We correlate blues and jazz and rock.
Yeah, blues and the blues
funk.
Away.
Yeah, so...
Beautiful music. Instrument, that harmonica, really. It's very understated.
It is understated.
People don't appreciate it enough.
Harp.
I think it's a...
Harp.
Mouth harp.
I still don't believe it can be a harp because a harp is this. Yeah, how do you change? How do you...
Well, it's called a blues harp.
Well, maybe he's a liar.
Could be. No, we'll have to Google it. Is Danny
a liar? Lawyer's a liar.
L-Y-R-E.
He's a liar bird. So that's our word of the week, blues.
Yeah, that is. And we've filled up now. We've wasted a few minutes talking about that because that's what we have to do on the show sometimes. Talk about
every week.
Meaningless.
But it's
nothing.
Been a lovely, pleasant show. We can see how many people have so much talent in the community.
Well, you know, and it's funny. I was going to bring up before this whole thing about, you know, Jews and music and how we've got this great history with Jews, both in musical theatre, which goes back to Irving Berlin and Rodgers
Roger
and Hammerstein,
and Hart,
all of that, all of that goes back. Well, Rodgers Hart goes back a long time, but it goes all the way back in classical music.
Mama Cass.
Classical music, both performers
Kraft.
And writers.
Yes.
But you know what is? And when we were growing up, what was the most popular? What was the best known piece of Jewish music that everyone knew and you heard it every single
Fiddler on the Roof?
No.
No, Bami Abyss to Shame.
No. I would say Hava Nagila.
Hava Nagila.
Sung by
Harry Belafonte.
Ah, yes.
Oh, that's right.
Exactly.
Really? He sang it?
Exactly.
Oh,
Harry Belafonte. We couldn't even find someone.
We couldn't find it?
No, you couldn't find anyone to sing Hava Nagila.
Oh.
Harry Belafonte. But
that's incredible. Daylight comes.
But I...
And we want to go.
I had this thing where you have a cousin sing, you know, in a daylight comes and we want to go home. So I want a chazun.
We would love a chazunish version of
it. On my Facebook, I posted a beautiful piece of music.
Knowledge.
It was actually from Cuba and it's called Havana Gila.
Ah, very
good. And she did this fabulous.
Great.
Unbelievable.
Terrific.
So if you want to go to my Facebook, Henry Greener Facebook, you'll find Havana Gila.
That's gorgeous.
Just
that
brilliant.
Is it. Okay. We're going
to
go out with our, we're going
to
go out with our trio back here.
Oh, beautiful.
And we'll see you next week.
Have a good Nagila.